thanks for stopping by my channel. Chef Stansberry, powered by Flavor Face, food, fun, and travel. I've got a very special dish for you today that we're gonna do, a spaghetti stuffed meatball. I invented this dish back in 2014, and I'm gonna go over the ingredients real quick. We're gonna make a quick marinara sauce. I got about a pound and a half of Roma tomatoes. I have two sweet onions. I've got a little bit of granulated sugar, bay leaf, a nice red wine. In this case, it's a Pinot Grigio, but a Cabernet or any dark, deep red wine would work. I've got some garlic that I've minced, some fresh minced garlic, some kosher salt, some beef stock, some black pepper, some Italian seasoning, some San Marzano tomatoes, some olive oil, and some tomato paste, okay? So let's get started. Let's hop into our marinara. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna drop this pound and a half of Roma tomatoes into some salted boiling water. I'm gonna drop these right in the water. And then we're just gonna salt this water pretty good. All right, now that we got those tomatoes going, we'll take our nice sweet Vidalia onion, and we'll just get a nice fine dice. Nice fine dice on the Vidalia onion. All right, this is a true secret to this meatball. This is a special ingredient to this meatball that you just won't believe, and I guarantee you've never seen it anywhere else. I've got about 2.5 cups to 3 cups of shredded Parmesan cheese, not the dry Parmesan that we sprinkle on our pizza, but this is the shredded Parmesan cheese. So you wanna put that on a sheet pan. I've sprayed it with a little pan spray just so it won't stick on the bottom. So I'm just gonna take a thin layer of Parmesan cheese, even as possible, and pop it in a 350 degree oven for about 25 to 30 minutes. All right, so we've got all of our onion cut, and we're gonna begin the marinara. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take some olive oil. I'm gonna put about 1/4 cup in this big blue over here, big blue, my favorite pan, and we're gonna sweat these onions with some garlic. So I'm just, it's enough to cover the bottom. Then we'll add the onion. And we'll add about two heaping tablespoons of fresh garlic. Now we're also gonna add our Italian seasoning. Now I tried to find some fresh basil today, but it's winter time, so I wasn't able to find any fresh basil. In the summer or spring, please use fresh basil. Basil and tomatoes go together like no other. But in this case, we're gonna use a nice Italian herb blend that I sure has oregano, thyme, marjoram. What else we got in there? Basil, parsley. So a good Italian blend will work, okay? So add that in. We got about 1.5 pounds of Romas, and we have a can of San Marzano tomatoes, so this will be about enough marinara for about a quart. I'd say about a quart, quart and a half of marinara sauce. So now that we got that going real good, we'll check our heat, probably medium-high heat. And we'll get all these guys dancing together in the pot. We're just gonna sweat those guys down until they start to caramelize and become sweet. Now meanwhile, remember the Roma tomatoes? We just boiled those long enough so we can peel the skin off. So I have these right here, okay? We're just dumping right in there. We'll get some cold water over them. Get some nice cold water over our Roma tomatoes, and we'll peel that skin off, okay? So we won't have any skin in our marinara sauce. Okay, so we've got our onions and our garlic and our Italian seasoning all sauteed away in the pan back here. So now our boiled Roma tomatoes that we just had, we're just gonna peel the skin off. Let me see if you get that skin off of your tomatoes. And we're gonna add that to this little bowl here. Now let's talk tomatoes for a minute. In this one, I chose to use Roma tomatoes and San Marzano tomatoes. Now the San Marzano tomatoes are known worldwide. They come right out of Naples in Italy, and they're a little thinner than a Roma tomato, and they have pointy edges. And then they have a thicker skin, fewer seeds, and they're much sweeter and more vibrant in flavor, okay? And they also have less acidity. So we're gonna mix those two tomatoes together to have a nice balance in our marinara sauce. But San Marzano, Italy, right outside of Naples, I'm sure we all know that's where pizza was originated, and the best tomatoes in the world, San Marzano. So if you see these anywhere out, grab those, and you won't be disappointed, I promise you. Okay, our onions are caramelizing just well. So we're gonna add some tomato paste to our onions and our garlic, okay? I'm gonna start off with maybe about a half cup. And then what you're gonna do is, you're gonna kind of brown this till it gets from that red to that like bronze color. And it kind of brings out the flavor in the tomato paste and just adds this richness, and it gets to marry with the garlic and all our Italian seasonings, garlic, the basil, the thyme, parsley, all those marry together. The sweetness of the onion all comes together. So you really wanna get some color on your tomato paste. That's a pro tip there. All right, so we've got our aromas all boiled and peeled. They're all looking good. Drain that little excess moisture off. So we're gonna pulse these in the food processor just to get them smooth, okay? So we're gonna add the San Marzano tomatoes and the Roma tomatoes to the food processor. Okay, we'll just add these to the processor. And we'll just give these a spin. Just wanna get it smooth. We don't want big chunks of tomato in our marinara. Just want a nice, smooth, deep, rich marinara. So we'll just make sure we pulse them to get them real smooth. And then we'll get them over to our pot with our red wine and our beef base and our bay leaf, and we'll let that go. We have a beautiful marinara coming up. All right, so we've got our tomato paste to a nice bronze color. Make sure not to let that burn, but you really want to bring that flavor out of tomato paste. Now you're gonna go in with your red wine. I'd probably say about a cup and a half, 2 cups. Let's do a cup and a half, 2 cups. We'll taste it at the end to make sure it's where it needs to be. But we really want that deep red flavor of that red wine, because you know red wine and red meat go together. You know, with chicken and seafood, you want white wine. Usually with a red meat, you want a red wine to accompany that. And they just go so well together to balance the flavors. So we're gonna let that wine reduce a little bit. We're gonna let some of the alcohol cook off. And as it reduces, it becomes more concentrated. So we want that really concentrated flavor, and also to marry and jump around in that pot with the garlic, the onions, the basil, the thyme. Let all those flavors mingle together, and then we'll have a nice marinara coming up. Okay, so we've let a little bit of that cook down and reduce. So now we're gonna go in with our tomatoes. And we're gonna go in with our beef base. I've got 2 cups of beef base right here. So I'm gonna start out with a cup to flavor it up. And we'll let those play around in that pot together. We'll taste it, look at the consistency, let it reduce and thicken. Taste again. If we need more stock, beef base, we'll add that. If we need more salt, we'll add that. At the very end, we'll add the sugar to add a tad bit of sweetness. All right, so we've got our beef base, our San Marzano tomatoes, our Roma tomatoes, our garlic, our onion, sweat it down all with the olive oil and Italian seasoning. Now we're gonna add our bay leaf. That bay leaf is gonna add another layer of flavor. We'll probably let this go for about an hour, hour and a half. And then we'll taste it and see where it is, and we're making our adjustments from there. It's time to jump into our spaghetti stuffed meatballs. Interesting fact, in 2014, I signed a contract with Major League Baseball to become an official food truck at the All-Star Game. How they chose me, I have no idea, but the caveat was I had 24 hours to submit a menu item. So I racked my brain, what can I do for Major League Baseball called me to have my food truck at the All-Star Game, what possibly could I do? So I came up with spaghetti and meatball on a stick. My whole idea around that was the spaghetti stuffed meatball would be the ball, the stick would be the baseball bat, and I came up with a triangle garlic crostini, which represented home base. Well, needless to say, I submitted that to Major League Baseball and I signed a contract the next day, and I was an official food truck at the 2014 Major League Baseball All-Star Game. And we're gonna work on that right now. First, we're gonna take some spaghetti. It's just a pound of spaghetti. And I have a pound and a half of ground beef. I have 2 eggs. I've got fresh parsley. I've got onion. And we're also gonna add some Parmesan cheese, but we'll get to that in a second. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take our spaghetti and we're gonna break these into little pieces, like as small as we can get them. I'd probably say a half an inch to an inch. But the smaller the better, because they have to fit with inside the meatball. Okay? So we're just gonna break these down to about half inch to inside pieces. And we're gonna get these over to that boiling water. And we're just gonna go about 5 to 6 minutes. We really want these to be al dente because they're gonna go in the meatball and then back in the oven again. So it's very important not to overcook these noodles on the first step. We want a nice al dente, no longer than 6 minutes. I'd probably say 5 to 6 minutes tops. All right, so we've got our pound of spaghetti all broken down in about inch-sized pieces. We're just gonna add these to our water. The water is already salted and oiled. We're gonna add these to our water and go for about 5 to 6 minutes for a nice al dente. Just gonna stir those. Make sure you stir it right away so they don't stick together and clump together. And we're gonna let those go for a nice 6 minutes or so. Now I'm gonna add my ground beef to my mixing bowl. Now you can, it's up to you. You can use a ground lamb with ground beef. You can use ground pork with ground beef, or you can use ground pork, ground beef, and ground lamb, equal parts. It's really up to you. In this case, I just did an 80-20 ground beef, the 80-20 being 80% lean and 20% fat. That seems to work for me to get me a nice meatball. However, I'm not opposed to the ground pork or the ground veal at all. They both work for me. In this case, it'll be ground beef. Okay, our spaghetti that we've broken into the inside pieces has been going for about 6 minutes. I got it to a perfect al dente. So we're just gonna pull that off the stove. And we're gonna drain this. And we're gonna shock it with cold water. We're gonna shock it. We wanna stop that cooking process right away. We don't want that to cook any further. So we're just gonna get some cold water and just dump it right over these noodles. Stop the cooking process, which is called shocking. So yeah, so just take cold water and just dump it right over that pasta until you can put your hand in it and it's cool to the touch. And then that way you know that your pasta's not continuing to cook while we're waiting to make our meatball mixture. We've got our noodles all boiled and chilled, shocked, it's ready to go. We've got our pound and a half of ground beef, okay? We're gonna get on to a very important step. I've got about 4 slices of sourdough bread. What we're gonna do, we're just gonna cut the edges off of this. Cut the edges off of that. Cube it smallly. I'll pop that right in this bowl. I'm gonna cut the edges off our bread. Cube it smallly. Get it right in our little bowl here. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna just cover these with some milk, okay? This is called milk-soaked breadcrumbs. Cover the breadcrumbs with some milk and make sure they absorb all the milk, and that's gonna soften the bread, and when it goes into your meatball, that's what makes that soft, moist meatball. Without this step, you won't have the soft meatball. So again, I took about 4 slices of sourdough bread, I cut the edges off, I diced it real small, and we covered it with milk, all right, for our milk-soaked breadcrumbs. All right, so now we've got our shredded Parmesan cheese in the oven. It's been right about 30 minutes now. So essentially what we're trying to achieve is just a large Parmesan cheese crisp, okay? So let's check it out and see what we got. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That That's exactly what we're looking for. See that golden brown right there, and see how it all came together, the cheese kind of blended together. Now we're gonna let that sit because we want it to harden additionally. We want it to harden just a little bit so we can add this to our meatball mixture. And what we're gonna do, we're just gonna break this up with our hands a bit. Just gonna break these up. Okay, we've got our brown shredded Parmesan cheese, and I've transferred it over. After we've broken the pieces, I've transferred it over to a food processor. So I'm just gonna get over here, and we're just gonna grind that up. All right. Yeah, so check that out. So now we've got just some fine crumbles of shredded Parmesan cheese, and that's gonna go right in our meatball mix. All right. So now first with our meatball mix, we're gonna add, again, 1.5 pounds of ground beef. I'm gonna add about 3/4 cup of minced, finely minced onion, okay? We're gonna add our Parmesan cheese. It's about 1/4 cup of the Parmesan cheese that we've toasted out. And we've broken in little pieces. We let harden, broken in little pieces. We grinded it. Now we're gonna add that to our meatball mixture. Now, we have our milk-soaked breadcrumbs. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna squeeze some of that moisture out as much as we can, and add that to our meatball mixture, just like so. Remember to squeeze as much moisture as you can out, because you don't want a wet meatball or a soggy meatball. You want a soft, moist meatball. So get all the excess liquid out of those little breadcrumbs. And we'll add that right to that. All right, so we've got our 1.5 pounds of ground beef. We've got our Parmesan crust that we've ran through the food processor and grinded up. We've got our milk-soaked breadcrumbs. We're gonna add about 2 tablespoons of fresh minced garlic. Okay. We're gonna do a little parsley. So we add about 2 tablespoons of fresh parsley. This is curly parsley. You can use fat leaf parsley if you like. I'm kinda prone to use curly parsley because it looks better for garnish. But flat leaf parsley cuts a little easier, and flat leaf parsley gives away a lot more flavor as well. But here you get the look, you get the brightness, and you get the flavor, and it makes for excellent garnish as well. So we'll garnish this at the very end. But we'll add about 1/4 cup of fresh parsley to our meatball mix. I'm gonna do about 2 tablespoons of kosher salt. And that's not a lot for 1.5 pounds of meat, but remember the cheese that we baked off is pretty salty too. We're gonna add a little bit, about 2 tablespoons, to wake that meat up, wake that garlic up, and wake that parsley up. And the last step, the noodles that we boiled and shot, I did about 1.5 cups of the noodles. So we're gonna add that to our mixture as well. And the last step is egg. We're gonna use egg as a binder. So I'm gonna use 2 cracked eggs. And that's gonna act as a binder. Okay, so we've got our 1.5 pounds of ground beef. We have our fresh parsley. We have our Parmesan breadcrumbs that we've ran through the food processor. We have our kosher salt. We have our fresh garlic, and we have our egg, and we have our spaghetti noodle. So we're just gonna give that all a mix together and let these guys play together. It's kind of like the same thing as meatloaf. You don't want to overmix your meatball mix because you want it to all stick together, and if you overwork it, it doesn't stick as well. It tends to fall apart. So let's not overwork it. Let's just make sure that everything's incorporated equally. Just want to fold and make sure that everything comes together as one. I'm happy with that. That looks pretty good. All right, there's our meatball mix. All right, we've got our meatball mix ready to go. I'm just gonna spray a little pan spray on here so they won't stick to the bottom and they'll release well. I'm gonna take a nice ice cream scoop. We're just gonna scoop a full scoop. We want these to be big. I'd probably say about 6 to 7 ounces. But remember, you're gonna get about 10% shrinkage. So they're gonna shrink just a bit. See how that looks like a giant ball? They're just beautiful. We'll put those in. We want each of them to be the same size. That's why the scoop is really important. Be the same size so they bake at the same size and the same temperature. We're gonna pop these in a 350 degree oven and let them go for about 35 to 40 minutes. We're looking for 155 degree internal temperature. Okay? So we're just gonna roll these and get these all in equal size. We'll get them in the oven and we'll come back and plate our spaghetti stuffed meatballs. All right, we've got our beautiful meatballs all rolled and ready for the oven. Okay, so we're gonna pop that in a 350 degree oven for about 35 to 40 minutes. I'm gonna watch them closely through the process, but we're looking for an internal temperature of 155 degrees. Okay, so let's pop these in the oven. Okay, our meatballs are in our oven. Again, 35 to 40 minutes, looking for an internal temperature of 155 degrees. Now let's check on our marinara. It's been going about an hour, hour and a half. I did use the full 2 cups of beef stock. I adjusted the seasoning with a little bit, about a tablespoon or so of sugar and about a tablespoon of salt, just to brighten up that balance and make it all equal. So I'm really pleased with the way the marinara came out. This is gonna be a great dish. I'm super, super excited. So meatballs coming up next. It's been about 35, 40 minutes on our meatballs, our spaghetti stuffed meatballs, excuse me. I've got them up to 155 degrees Fahrenheit in the center, so that's plenty done. Expect some carryover time. It'll probably go up another 5 or 10 degrees, even though when we bring them out the oven, just from the internal temperature. So let's take a peek at these. Oh Lord, look at this. Oh wow, look at that. Look at that golden brown. Look at those meatballs. Listen to that sizzle whizzle. For shizzle. All right, so we've got our beautiful meatballs. Now it's time to plate. Okay, the beautiful meatballs are out the oven. Now let's just see how moist this guy is. I'm really excited about this. Check this out. Ooh-wee. Look at that. Look how moist. Full of flavor and garlic, spaghetti, and Parmesan. And what I love about the dry Parmesan aspect of this dish when we toasted our Parmesan and ran it through the food processor is there's no melty cheese in here. It's just nuggets, golden nuggets of flavor all throughout. And the moist breadcrumbs that we did, it allows the spaghetti not to dry out, and it allows the meatball not to dry out, it allows the Parmesan not to dry out, and you just got a mouthful of flavor each bite. I've got some sourdough garlic bread that I've toasted. We're gonna add a little height right here with that. We're just gonna take one of our beautiful meatballs, place that right in the center. Remember that beautiful marinara we worked on earlier? We're gonna top that with the marinara. Okay. Now we're gonna add some Parmesan. We're gonna add provolone cheese to the top. And we're gonna torch that bad boy. Now normally you can just pop it in the oven, top it with your marinara, top it with your Parmesan, top it with your provolone, excuse me, top it with your provolone. About 5-10 minutes in a 350 degree oven and you'll get the same effect. We just wanted to be fancy. And there we go. Check that out. Now check that out. So So there it is, the beautiful spaghetti stuffed meatball. Now remember, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and that little bell on the bottom right, that notification button, tap that guy for me, and you'll get a notification every time I post.